Hi, today I'm going to show you how to knit this raglan dog sweater. Let's get started. Today, I'm going to show you how to knit this complete seamless dog sweater with sleeves. That's the sleeve line and inside as well. And this is 100% seamless. Okay? You can make the sleeve longer if you want. That's the chest part and slowly increasing. And that's the neck rib. I use new technique to make it thicker and looks professional knitting. And I also use new technique to bind up. I name it Knit Two Together Bind Off. It looks completely different texture. I made the thick neck at the top, so I want to use different technique for the bottom so it doesn't look very chunky. And I'm glad I did it. And same as the sleeve ending. Also, this is inside of the sweater. There is no seam. Okay? And all the yarn needle details are in my description box. Okay? Cast on. Multiple of 6. I made 66. Sometimes people ask me, how did I figure it out the cast on number? The one thing I can say is I tried so many times. That's how I figured it out. Maybe start with 40, 50, 60. I knit few rows and put it on to my dog. Then I found around 60 to 70 is the good cast on number for my dog. This is for my 10-pound Yorkie. So if your dog is smaller, maybe start with smaller number. Okay, so after cast on, I will connect both ends and then knit around, then start making rib. The rib should be repeat off, knit one and purl one until your desired length times 2. So my desired length of the rib was 2 inch. So I made rib about 4 inch total. Okay? So let's start making rib. And I use the magic loop technique because I don't have the perfect length of the cable. If you never done magic loop technique, I put the link in my description box, so please take a look. Okay, so let's start. The rib, repeat off, knit one, and purl one. And from the second row, you just knit over knit stitch and purl over purl stitch. So you just have to be very careful on the first row. Repeat off, knit one, and purl one. I finished the neck rib, about 4 inches. Now, let's make a double rib neck. Simple. You just have to fold inward. That's it. Okay? That's the right side, and fold inward, like that. First stitch, knitting, right? Which means the back of the knitting stitch is purl. So you're looking at the purl stitch on the wrong side right there, and the end of the purl, you pick up the stitch like that, okay? Knit stitch on the right and purl stitch on the wrong, pick up like that, then knit those two together. So you connect top and bottom ends to create the double rib. So next, on the right side, there is the purl stitch, which means knitting stitch on the wrong side. So the top of the knitting, you have to pick up the stitch like that. And this time, you make purl because the rib was repeat of knit one and purl one. So you follow that rule. There we go. Then next should be knit, which means purl on the wrong side. So the top of the purl stitch, you have to pick one stitch right there. And this is knitting, so knit two together. This is it. Okay, you have to do around. There you go. One more time. This is purl on the right side, which means knit on the wrong side. So pick up the one stitch on top of the knit on the wrong side, then purl two together this time. Okay? Purl two together. And you just have to be careful which stitch you're picking up, right? Has to be straight down. Okay? So it's easy, but take your time. Okay? Make sure you're picking up the right stitch. If you don't like this texture, or if this is too much, you don't have to. Okay? I just wanna, you know, try something different. Okay? This is my just a regular rib. It's completely fine. Okay, you can fold it or, you know, make it straight. It doesn't really matter. It's really up to you, you know, to make it single rib or double rib neck. But new technique, why not, right? And it looks a little bit more professional knitting. Now you need magic number. Whole stitch divide by 6. My magic number is 66 divided by 6 equal 11. So 11 is my magic number. Now set it up the marker. At the very beginning, there's the begin marker. That's actually marker A. Then you knit the number of your magic number. For me, knit 11. Then place the B marker. Then knit another 11 stitch for me, or your magic number. Then place the C marker. Then again, knit 11 for me. Then place the D marker. After place the D marker, you don't have to do anything, but make sure you have enough stitch, which is your magic number times 3. My magic number was 11. 11 times 3 is 33. I have 33 stitch between D marker and A marker. So this is what I did. From marker D and A, the bigger area, that's for dog's back. Okay, that's the back. And in front of the back, which is between marker B and C, that's dog's chest. Then the side part, that's gotta be dog's sleeve. After this, I am going to increase here and there. Okay, usually around the marker area. Slowly increase, you know, especially the sleeve area. Okay, so again, you have to knit one round, no increasing, no nothing. Okay, so I already put the marker, but I'm gonna make sure, you know, one more time I place the marker right area. So again, from the beginning, I knit 11, which is my magic number, and I place the B marker after I knit 11. So please follow my instruction. You know, the only difference is, you know, between D and A, but you don't really have to count. What's left between D and A should be magic number times 3. For me, there were 33 stitches for dog's back. Increase in row number 1. Every single marker you have to increase before and after. Okay? Begin marker, which is A. Knit 1. Then make one left because it's left side of the marker. Pick up the running thread from the front like that. Then knit back of that loop. This is make one left. Okay? So again, after the begin marker, knit one. Then make one left. Then knit until last one stitch before next marker. You have to do exactly same thing every marker. Okay? So knit until one last stitch. Then make one right because it's now right side of the marker. That's how you remember. Pick up the running thread from the back, then knit one there, then knit last one stitch, then slide the marker. Then again, after the marker, you have to increase one more, right? So knit one, then now left side of the marker, so make one left, which is picking up the running thread from front. Then use the back loop, knit one there. And you have to do this every marker, which means you increase total of 8 stitch on the increasing row number 1. Okay, so there's a marker, right side and left side. You always increase one each. Okay, here comes the begin marker. You started after the begin marker, so please do not forget, just before the begin marker, you have to do make one right because it's right side. Okay, right side, pick up the running thread from the back, then knit there, then knit one. Okay, then increase in row number 2, all knit, very straightforward. Okay, remember, increase in row number 1, increase 8 stitch total because there's 4 stitch A to D, right? So, important thing is, before the begin marker, don't forget to increase one there, okay? Now, increasing row number three. I add one more marker there, which indicates that's the chest part, okay? Because I want to increase inside of the sleeve, okay? Which means chest and back, you don't increase. Only between A and B and C and D, okay? No increasing back and chest. And increasing technique is same, okay? But I will show you. Okay, that's the begin marker. So between A and B, that's a sleeve. So make knit one, then make one left. Okay, then knit until one last stitch before the B marker. And approaching B marker, which is inside of the sleeve. Okay, now make one right, because right side of the B marker. Then knit one, slide the B marker. Now between B and C is chest, that's the chest marker. So just knit straight, then slide the marker, which is C marker. After slide the C marker, you have to increase because it's now C and D is sleeve. Okay, so knit one. I actually forgot to knit one, and you know, I made the make one left, but knit one, then make one left. Okay, then knit until one last stitch before the D marker, okay? And approaching D marker now. So now it's a right side of the D marker inside of the sleeve, so make one right there. And maybe I'm gonna write the detail for the make one right and make one left in my description box. Okay, and after the D marker until the begin marker, that's the back. So you just knit straight, no increasing. That's row number three. And increasing row number four is all knit. Then repeat increasing row number one to row number four until the sleeve length reaches dog's armpit. Okay, so again, increasing row number one, you increase 8 stitches total, and increasing row number three, increase only 4 stitch, which is inside of the sleeve. That's it. And then now I want to talk about the leash opening on the back. Okay, so you have to do repeat of increasing row number one and row number four. And while you're doing it, you have to think about the leash opening as well. Okay? Leash opening, it's really up to you. Depend on the dog harness, right? But you should be starting on the increasing row number two, okay? Because the as you know, increasing row three, you just increase the inside of the sleeve. You're not gonna increase any back part, right? So if you start increasing row number two, which means you don't really have to worry about any, you know, increasing thing on the back part. So anyway, this is the increasing row Number two, I already count stitches and, you know, where I want to put the, you know, leash opening. So I decide 13 stitch I want to bind off right in the middle of the back sweater. So I am binding off right now 13 stitches. Okay? And this is the last bind off, 13 stitch right there. Then you just keep knitting. Now increasing row number 3, which is you just increase inside of the sleeve, that's it, right? So just keep knitting until the top of the leash opening. This is increasing row number 3. That's why I'm increasing right there, which is, you know, inside of the sleeve. Then keep knitting. That's the back part, right? So just keep knitting until above the bind off. Well, you know, you have to stop because no more stitch because you bind off in the previous row, right? So whenever you have encountered no more stitch, now you have to, you know, create the new stitch. I bind off 13 stitch in previous row, so I add 13 new cast like that. Okay? Then after you add the new cast, 13 of them, just keep knitting. You know, pretend nothing happened. And, you know, next row is increasing row number 4, which is all knit. So you don't really have to worry about any increasing. So just keep knitting. Okay? Again, it's really up to you where to start. You can, you know, start binding off on the increasing row number 1. But if it's, you know, the row number 1, you have to think about the increasing. You have to think about the leash opening. It's kind of busy. So I picked the you know, row number 2. You know, all knit. And increasing row 3 is, you know, increasing row, but only for the sleeves. Okay? So right now, I'm actually knitting right on the new cast. You know, just struggle sometimes, but take your time. Okay? This is how it looks. Then keep knitting. And there we go. I think I reached enough length. I repeated row number 1 to row number 4, total of 5 times. And finally, the sleeve reaches under his armpit. So now let's separate the sleeves and body. You need scrap yarn. So transfer all the sleeve stitch onto the scrap yarn. Okay? You know, from A to B, that's the first sleeve, right? So you have to transfer every single stitch in between marker A and B. Okay? And then you tie the knot and just leave it there. Then you have to actually reconnect the body part, right? But, you know, I will tell you in a moment. Okay? So I just finished the transfer onto the thread. And I tied the knot. It's a little bit, you know, off camera. But I'm actually tying the knot for the sleeve. So on the right needle, there's the stitch for back, and left needle, now the chest, right? So that's the sleeve part and you just leave it alone. Now you reconnect chest and back. You have to add at least one cast in between back and chest. Okay? My dog is very skinny, so I need to add only one cast. But if you have chunky, you know, dog like a French bulldog or, you know, American bulldog, or, you know, a chubby dog, maybe you need add more cast because, you know, dog does want to wear tight sweater, right? So whenever you put the sweater on to make sure sleeve is long enough, you kind of, you know, check how many, you know, cast you need. Okay, so I add one cast, at least one cast or more. Then I knit until the other side of the sleeve. Then now you need one more scrap yarn. Same thing. Transfer all the sleeve stitch onto the scrap yarn and then reconnect the chest and, you know, the back, this side again with same amount of the cast. Okay, I add one, so I am going to add one new cast there, then reconnect. There you go, one cast. Again, if you have big tummy, you know, muscular dog, you might have to add three or four. But if you actually knit longer length of the sleeve, you know, you might not need that many. So it's really up to you. After I separate them, I put sweater on my dog and make sure everything is right size. It's a little bit, you know, big around the chest, but it doesn't really matter. My dog doesn't like the very tight sweater, right? So this is fine. After this, it's easy. You just have to knit around and around for the body. And I stop around 8 inches from the bottom of the neck because he's a boy and, you know, shorter tummy for peepee, right? So now I use the stitch holder to transfer his tummy stitch, okay? Because, you know, I will reconnect again, so I want to keep it. I don't want to bind off and knit up, you know, so many, you know, stitches there. So I am going to keep the tummy stitch onto the stitch holder like that. Now it's not round. You have to knit back and forth. Start from the wrong side. Decreasing row number one on wrong side. It's all purl. I'm actually going to finish the body part. Okay? So decreasing row number one, wrong side. All purl. After this, you have to turn the work. Then, decreasing row number two, right side. Now I am going to decrease both sides. Knit one, then SSK. Slip, slip, knit, which decrease one stitch there. Then knit until last three stitch. Then knit two together there, then knit one. Very straightforward. Okay? Here comes end of the decreasing row number two. Three stitch left, then knit two together there, then knit one. So you have to repeat decreasing row number one and row number two until your desired length. Okay, I probably needed it about 2 inch, something like that, I guess. You can, you know, knit longer if you like, you know, or shorter. It's really up to you. Okay? And you have to reconnect, but has to be right side. So I'm gonna, you know, knit right side using the decreasing technique still. Is knit one, then SSK, then knit across until 3 stitch, then knit 2 together and knit 1. There you go. Knit 2 together and knit 1. Now on the side there's no more stitch. Okay, so before you knit up the side, you have to transfer the tummy stitch back onto the needle, the other side of the needle. Okay, let's get prepared. Okay, now it's all good. Then for the side, you have to knit up right on the edge you have to use. Then, you know, you just knit. Pretend that you have a stitch there. And I pick up 8 stitch there. You have to count because you have the other side. And you would like to, you know, knit up same amount of the stitch. And after you knit up, you just start knitting tummy stitch. And you reconnect this side. Okay, there you go. Start just knitting tummy stitch. Then after the tummy, there's a side. And again, I knit up 8 for the other side. So I am going to knit up 8 this side too. If you want to make the regular rib after this, the stitch count should be multiple of 2 because the rib should be repeat of knit 1 and purl 1. But for me, I'm not making any rib anymore. So I don't really have to count, you know, the stitches. Okay, so I knit about 1 inch after this, you know, just all knit, okay, because I'm not making any, you know, rib anymore. So I knit about 1 inch. Now I am going to do bind off, which is knit 2 together bind off. Knit 1, then now next stitch in the previous row. You put the right needle from the back like that, and there's the running thread there, okay? You grab that running thread just like that, kind of flip, then pick up the stud stitch with the left needle like that, and knit 2 together there. Then pass the previous stitch over, just like that. Okay, one more time. Now, the right needle you put from behind in previous stitch. Okay, okay, I'll show you bigger, just like that. Okay, then there's the running thread right underneath. You grab the stitch like that, and from the front, you grab it with the left needle. Then knit 2 together. Then pass the switch over. Okay? That's it. Okay? And if you don't quite understand, go back and watch my video carefully again. Okay? And this is how it looks. I like this texture sometimes. You know, the big chunky on top around the neck. So bottom, I kind of want to have simple. Okay? But I didn't want to do just a regular, you know, bind off. Okay, so let's do the sleeve. Transfer all the sleeve stitch onto the needle. Obviously, only one side. Then, with the new ball of yarn, okay, knit one round. And that opening area, you gotta knit up. And I will tell you in a minute. Okay, so rejoin the yarn and knit one round. Okay, then I'll tell you what to do, you know, the other side. Okay, so I knit kind of one round, and now underneath on the armpit, do you remember I add one cast? Okay, so you have to knit up the number you add for the cast, right? Plus two. So both side of the new cast, you have to pick one each. So I pick one before the cast. Then right on near the cast, I pick one. Then after the cast, I knit up one more. So total of three. There we go. Then you will knit one more row. I add the begin marker for just in case. Then you knit until last stitch of the original sleeve stitch. Okay, I'm gonna make little trick there. Okay, so now end of the row number two. Again, you need one last original sleeve stitch and the first knit up stitch. I made three knit up, so right there, and you use those two stitch, then SSK, okay? Last original sleeve stitch and first knit up stitch, you make SSK there. There you go, SSK. Then knit one. Okay, now you have last knit up stitch, right? And there's the begin marker there. So I am going to move stitch and marker. I'm gonna put the begin marker there. And on the left needle, you have last knit up stitch and first original sleeve stitch. You make knit two together there. Why I have to do this? Because I tried to minimize the hole around the armpit. Okay? There you go. Then knit few rows. Depend on, you know, your preference. I knit, I think, four rows, then do the knit two together bind off. There you go. I finished. There's not much hole and a little bit, you know, noticeable, but don't worry. Whenever you weave the yarn ends off, you can, you know, close that hole. It's really up to you. whether you do the SSK and NITU together. You don't really have to if you don't want to or if it's too difficult, but this way, you know, you can avoid. I mean, you can't really avoid everything, but you can minimize the hole under the armpit. Okay? And I just did the, you know, one side of the sleeve, so you have to do exactly same thing for the other side. Okay? There you go. I really like the knit two together bind off because it's, you know, simple, but, you know, different texture, right? There we go. So transfer all the sleeve stitch for the other side and do same thing again. There you go. I finished. I like that, you know, the sleeve raglan line there and chest. It's perfect. Again, you know, if this chest is too small, you can add a little bit more when you, you know, the separate the sleeve and reconnect the chest and back. So you can adjust the sizes. And I love that texture again at the very bottom, you know, bind off. Okay? So that's about it. Enjoy knitting. Also, I'll show you a little bit more, you know, my dog with the sweater on after this. Okay? This is the yarn I use. Also, check my description box. Here comes my doggy. New sweater on. He's sniffing and sniffing. Bye for now.